been a long time since I've stood up in front of your church like this. I want you to know it's an honor. This next song, I know you've all heard it many times, it's called It As Well. But how many knows the story behind it? You know, a lot of times in church, we hear these catchy tunes, the words seem to not mean that much. I was telling the guys yesterday, when you're in the car, you're going down the road, and you got the radio on, how many times during the day do you remember that last song that you heard? It keeps going over and over and over in your mind. If it's a song of glory, a song of praise, the first time you reach adversary, you start having some kind of problem, confrontation, you start having an argument with a coworker, what's going to come to your mind first? That song. It's in the back of your mind. It's going to be going over and over. Songs mean a lot more than entertainment or form of worship. The Bible says that God inhabits our praise. This is one of the few things that we can give God that He don't already have. We have free will. We were given the ability to choose whether to worship God or not. Us choosing to worship Him is greater than noble. And whenever He inhabits our praise, He returns a gift to us. We'll go over the story with you real quick. Horatio Stafford was a successful lawyer and a businessman in Chicago. He had a wife, Anna, and five children. In 1871, his son died of pneumonia. At a young age, the same year, their business was lost in the Great Chicago Fire. In 1973, his business was bankrupt. He had no way of income. He sent his wife and his four children off to Europe on a French ocean liner. He stayed in Chicago to close up a few things, and he was going to join them later. 4 days into their journey, their ship collided with an iron-hulled Scottish ship. The boat sank, taking 226 passengers with it. Days later, his wife was found floating in the water alive, with all four children drowned. Soon after, Stafford was traveling to meet his wife, and as they crossed over the place where the ship had sank and his four children had drowned, the captain told him where they were. Stafford made a decision at that time. Think about it. He'd already lost a son. He lost four other children that drowned right where he was at. His wife was probably not in the best of health after floating out there for 4 days. He was broke. He had nothing. He crosses over this point and he had a choice to make. Do I turn into myself? Do I turn to alcohol? Do I turn to drugs? Do I turn against my Creator and ask Him why? Why have you done this to me? Why has all this happened? I've always served you. Or do you look at God and bow to His wisdom and realize that He knows what's going on and there's a reason all this happened? Horatio made the right choice. And soon after that, he wrote the song, It As Well. The couple later had three more children. One of them died at pneumonia when he was age four. In 1981, the Staffords moved to Jerusalem, where Horatio died and was buried. Philippians 4:7, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, shall keep your hearts and your minds through Jesus Christ. When that time comes in your life, and we all face it, and you don't know where to turn, and you ask God why has this happened to me? Don't ask why. Ask God why. What are you doing? You know what's going on. Don't be embarrassed, burdened, and continue to glorify. And it will all come out in the end.
Amen.